I hope you watched part one, as this is part two of this two-part episode all about the structure of logs. My name is Jay Clifford, and this is Zero to Hero, a beginner's guide to Loki. Buckle up, as this episode is all about log formatting. Let's quickly recap about what we learned in part one. We imagined a log entry as a Lego set, with the log components such as timestamp, severity level, and message as the Lego blocks. If we continue with this analogy, log formats are like Lego manuals. They provide the method for assembling these blocks together and how we represent them to the end user. In short, like Lego, there are many different ways log entries can be structured. Today, we'll focus on the three most common types you will see day to day. Interestingly, one of the most common types of logs still used by developers today is plain text. This is the natural successor to print statements and provides the most amount of freedom in its design. Plain text entries can be appended to many different file types and, in general, be universally opened by most operating systems. One of the primary problems with this format of log is actually due to that flexibility and lack of standardization. Essentially, developers can structure logs how they wish, which makes these types of logs difficult and costly to pass. Next are structured logs, which you'll be hearing a lot about in this series. This is where we take our log components and format them within a common data format such as JSON, XML, or YAML. The key benefit here is that it reduces the friction of automatically passing logs with other data processing tools such as a log aggregator. However, in general, as the complexity of the log grows within a structured log file, it can become more difficult for a developer to read directly compared to a plain text file. Lastly, the third most common type of log is an interesting one. Originally designed in the 1980s, syslog is one of the earliest standards for logging and managing messages in a network environment. Syslog actually quickly became the de facto standard for logging systems on Unix systems and later on a wide range of devices and platforms, such as routers, firewalls, and even some Windows applications. One of the primary drawbacks of using syslog within a modern logging architecture is its limited ability to represent metadata within distributed systems. We have discussed a lot of theory around log components and their representation. What we will do next is check out a small interactive demo you can try online to see how it all comes together. You can find the link in the description below. In this demo, we've created a small messaging board application, similar to Hacker News or Reddit. The idea is users can post messages and upvote posts that they like. We have been good developers and orchestrated our application code with a logging framework. So when we run different actions within our application, a log entry is appended to a log file. Let's jump into our log file and see how this logging framework represents these log entries. We can see our log entry structure is quite unique, a hybrid between plain text and structured, since it utilizes key value pairs. The first component we can see is the severity level, which currently shows info, so our application is in normal running conditions. Let's spice things up a bit and generate some errors by incorrectly filling out the form and see what happens. As you can see, log entries are now being flagged with the level error, since our application failed to process the user's entry. As suggested in part one of this video, the error shows a significant failure, in this case failing to process the data entry, but does not cause the entire program to crash. We have also introduced an interesting crossover of metrics into our logs called duration. We will focus on how we can utilize this metric in another video. As we move through the series, we'll be building up this demo to add more interesting components to this log. And with that, we've come to the end of our two-part episode on the structure of logs. Now, you might be asking, Jay, when are we going to start talking about ingesting logs into Loki? Have no fear, this is currently the end of our theory content around logs. Now, there has been a method to my madness. So when we start to release lessons around Loki ingest, setup, and query, this theory will help provide the grounding to understanding why Loki works the way it does. Until next time, make sure you check out our Grafana for Beginners series and join our wonderful community on Slack and Discourse. My name is Jay Clifford. Thank you for watching. Stay curious.